Namaste everyone, I am Gyan and you are learning the Kotlin programming language. In this video, we will install Kotlin on Ubuntu and write our first Kotlin program on the Ubuntu. To install and use Kotlin, the Java or at least JRE must should be present on the system. We need to open the official website of Kotlin, that is kotlinlang.org. Let's go to this website. This is the kotlinlang.org. Scroll below. You can see here there are various download links. We need to download the standalone compiler. So click on the download compiler. Now we can get the compiler from GitHub releases. Click on the GitHub releases. This is the GitHub account of the JetBrains. JetBrains is the creator of Kotlin. Download this zip file. Click on here. Same zip file can be downloaded for Windows and same zip file can be downloaded for Linux. So this 28.7 MB zip file, we need to download it. I want to save it on the desktop. Save it here. Download completed. Let's go to the desktop. This is a desktop. Right click on here and click on the extract here. We extracted the Kotlin. If you go in the folder, you can find the bin directory, and this directory contains various executable files. Using the terminal, we need to present in the directory where the executable files of Kotlin is present. Then only we can run the Kotlin. So let's go to the bin subdirectory of Kotlin, cd desktop kotlin bin. And here we are. Run the command ls to see what is in the current directory. And we have the various executable files like Kotlin, Kotlin C, Kotlin C.js, and Kotlin C.jvm. If I write here ./Kotlin, it will execute fine. But throw error because we are not providing any file name here. The error is please specify at least one name or file to run. So this is not a good idea to change our directory to a folder which contains the executable of Kotlin. We want to run Kotlin from anywhere, and for that we need to update the path variable. If you don't know what is the path variable, or if you are new to the Linux operating system, then please visit the session 1 of Java and Web installation and first program. The link is given in the video description below. There you can learn the conceptual way of Java installation on Windows and Ubuntu, and this is similar for Kotlin installation. So finally we need to update the path variable. Come to the home directory, write cd, press enter, you will come to the home directory. Clear the screen. And to update the path variable, there are various ways to update the path variable. I will not discuss all the ways because all the ways has been discussed in the session 1 of Java and Web. Here I will discuss just the permanent way of setting the path variable. Open .bashrc file. Bashrc file is present in the home directory. To open a file, you can use the editor of your choice. I am using editor of my choice. So I suggest you to open the gedit editor, but I will use vi editor. Because I like vi editor, I am more used to a vi editor. Open vi.bashrc. This is the .bashrc file. Come at last. And here you need to provide the path variable. Right here. Export path is equal to $path colon. Then we need to write the directory name where the executable of Kotlin is present. Go to the directory where Kotlin executables are present. Right click on any executable, click on properties, and this is the location. Copy this location and then paste it here. Erase this added directory and paste it here. Paste. So this is the path where Kotlin executable is present. Now this directory has been added to the path variable. Save and exit. The new path variable will not be effective in the currently open terminal. You need to open the new terminal if you want the path variable to be effective. Open the new terminal. And right here Kotlin. Now Kotlin executes from the home directory even it is not present in the home directory and showing an error. Please specify at least one name or file to run. So here we need to write our first Kotlin program. Open hello world.kotlin. .kt. The extension kt denotes the Kotlin. So open hello world.kt. Here we need to write the Kotlin program. Let me copy the Kotlin program from the Kotlin official website. This is the Kotlin program I want to copy. Copy it and paste it here. Remove the extra characters from the program. This is our first Kotlin program. Let me save and compile it. For compilation, you need to write Kotlin C, just like Java C. Kotlin C, hello world.kt. We created the Kotlin file in the home directory, but I want to create it on the desktop so that it is most visible to you. My home directory contains too many files. It will not be visible to you clearly. So let me copy the hello world.kt file on desktop and then recompile it. Cp hello world.kt. I want to copy it to desktop. I copied the file to desktop. Then again recompile it. Change our directory to the desktop, cd desktop, and then compile the Kotlin. Kotlin C hello world.kt. It compiles fine and created two extra files. One is the directory named meta-inf and other one is a class file hello world.kt.class. So we need to pass this class name to the Kotlin. Write here Kotlin hello world.kt. You do not have to pass full file name to the Kotlin. You just need to pass the class name only. Pass only hello world kt. And remember that here k is the capital letter, not a small letter. Press enter. It executes fine and print hello world. So we did all these things. The same zip file, the same compiler works on both Windows and Linux. And also we updated the path variable. Like this, we already written the file hello world.kt and provided this content in that file. Here semicolon is optional in Kotlin. You may or may not write the semicolon. If you try to run the class file created by Kotlin using JVM directly, it will throw error. Let me try to run the class file created by Kotlin using JVM. First clear the screen and write Java class name hello world.kt. Press enter. So here JVM throws the error if we try to pass the class name created by Kotlin to the JVM. That's all for this video guys. Don't forget to like and share this video. Subscribe this channel if you are new and leave your valuable comments in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.